Calibration of the working standards. Two UV working standards, UVWS, were calibrated from 200 nanometers to 400 nanometers by a series of measurements at the Ultraviolet Spectral Comparator Facility, UVSCF, visible to near-infrared spectral comparator facility VIS/near-SCF, and SURF with various C-photodiode UV transfer standards and trap detectors. The UVWS were calibrated with a VIS trap at the VIS/near-SCF from 405 nanometers to 500 nanometers. The combination of the UV transfer standards and the VIS trap provides the lowest uncertainties over the entire UVWS calibration range. The calibration chain for the UV working standards is shown in. The calibration chain for the ultraviolet working standards, UVWS. The responsivity of the UVWS was determined by an average of 3 independent scans against each UVTS and VIS trap. As with the VIS-WS, each UVWS was removed from the SCF and realigned between each scan. The resulting data from the transfer standards were combined to create a single scale from 200 nanometers to 500 nanometers for the UVWS. Ultraviolet Spectral Comparator, UVSCF. The UVSCF is a monochromator-based system that measures the uniformity and spectral power responsivity of photodetectors in the 200 nanometers to 500 nanometers spectral region. The UVSCF is very similar in configuration and operation to the VIS/near-SCF. Only the differences between the two will be described. A diagram of the UVSCF is shown in Figure 5. Ultraviolet Spectral Comparator Facility, UVSCF. UV-enhanced silicon photodiodes serve as the working standards for the UVSCF. A rotary stage is used in the UVSCF. Currently only one test detector at a time can be measured. The test and working standard detectors are fixed onto optical mounts that rotate and tilt. Motorized translation stages position the test detector in the horizontal and vertical planes while the working standards are positioned manually. High accuracy UV standard radiometer, Hoser as the main radiation testing facility, the radiometer has an important position in the radiation field. But the radiometer using in the practical application doesn't have responsivity standard, needs to be calibrated by the standard source. Because of the error introducing in the calibration procedure, the radiometer uncertainty will reduce. So the radiometer doesn't have a good performance in the radiation application. For solving the problem discussing above, the Hoser had been established using the NIST Working Standards Detector as a core element. A series of capability testing had been made to confirm its stability. And the Hoser responsivity standard had been deduced at the basic of the NIST detector standard. The uncertainty analyzing also had been done. Finally, there is a radiometer with high stability, high accuracy and self-responsivity standard that would have a great performance in the calibrating application. The design concept of the Hoser is compact structure, easy to carrying on, simple interior constitution and stability performance. And there is no other optical element in the Hoser. So the responsivity standard can be deduced with high accuracy. For satisfying the requirement listing above, the Hoser has been established using the NIST Working Standards Detector as a core element, and adding the light filter splitting system, motor driving system and data acquisition system. The structure of the whole facility is shown in Fig.6. The structure of the Hoser. The incident light passed through the lightproof canister, filter, and arrives at the receive area of the detector. There is three UV filter with different wavelength fitting on the filter wheel. The three wavelengths are 313 nanometers, 352 nanometers, 365 nanometers. The filter wheel is controlled by the motor driving to make sure different wavelength light passing through. The data acquisition system collects the detector signal and saves it on the computer. According to the responsivity standard of the Hoser, the incident optical radiation can be calculated with the data. As the core element of the Hoser, the detector's performances will affect the accuracy and stability of the Hoser. So the detector choosing is very important. According to the design requirement of the Hoser, a detector with good stability, great linearity, compacting structure, wide response wavelength range and self-responsivity will be used standard. After considering all the factor, the NIST Working Standard Detector S2281 will be the best choice. The advantage of the NIST detector will display obviously in a series of testing results by comparing with the Hamamatsu detector.